All right, so it seems now it'll be easier than ever to print your own functioning and reliable Glock, and probably any other handgun you'd like, or maybe even a dreaded assault rifle can be yours with the click of a button. I think this simply brings the futility of gun laws directly to the forefront. How will passing a law prevent someone intent on doing harm to others from getting a gun? None of the laws we've had before, which were very plentiful, prevented this from happening, so now you're really out of luck when it comes to legislating this problem away. To put this in perspective, we have a drug problem in the U.S. Drugs have to be grown or manufactured, processed, packed, and smuggled to distribution points throughout the U.S. to be transported to different cities. These drugs are obviously illegal, and we spend billions to try and stem the tide of drugs, and government fails miserably at this. Hell, forget drugs being sold on the streets, we can't even keep them out of prisons. So why would anyone think that we would be able to do that with guns, especially now that one could manufacture a gun easily in their own living room? It's like duct taping a cracked dam and thinking it'll hold. And there is that old cliche yet true statement that if you outlaw guns, only outlaws will have guns. Well, now that's even more true. I think if you were to ban the 3D printing of guns, most people who like to be on the good side of the law will actually obey that. But for those who are intent on doing harm to people with a firearm, all they need is to own or to simply know someone who owns a 3D printer, and voila, that violent person is now armed while the more legally conscious person has a more difficult time acquiring a gun. That's not a good situation to be in. Now, not all is lost. Gun violence obviously exists, and there are certainly things we could be doing to decrease it. But legislating this issue away will be more fruitless now than it ever has been. But thankfully, like I said, there are things that you can do. There are things you can focus on and efforts you can put forth that might actually do some good. First thing you do is focus on getting the government out of the drug prohibition business. A sizable chunk of our gun violence stems from the fact that within a black market, like the drug market, it is profitable to murder some people to garner their share of the market. You legalize drugs, and that is a guarantee that a good number of our gun homicide cases decrease. Same exact thing happened when we ended prohibition of alcohol. It all of a sudden was not profitable to go to war with another faction to make sure you were the only seller in town. Nowadays, you just see some sales on whiskey or something, and there's no gun violence required. Second, boycott mainstream media outlets that put the names, faces, life stories, and manifestos of gun-wielding murderers on the television for millions to see. All this does is send a message to the next lonely, frustrated guy that if he goes down the path of murder, he'll get what he wants, and the entire nation will know his face and name, and they will live in infamy. Call me crazy, but that's not a good message to be sending. Make sure the advertisers on those media outlets know that when those media outlets act irresponsibly in this manner, they are not going to sell as many units as they were hoping for. If you can find the determination to do this, you might actually end up helping. But if all you can do is picket for more laws, then dare I say, you are not helping one iota. But all right, thanks for listening. Like and subscribe for more stuff like this, and you take it easy.